Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Alyssa Marie here, just in case you're new. Today we are getting all into gels and I'm gonna show y'all exactly how you can choose the right gel for you based on your hair type, as well as based on the look that you're kind of going for. Before we jump straight into all the details, please do make sure that you are subscribed to my channel. Y'all won't regret it. And if you wanna make sure that you never miss a new video ever again, hit that notification bell as well, and you get a little email every time a new video is dropped. Let's jump straight in. All right, so there are basically two types of gels, and how I like to categorize them are the jelly gels and then the not so jelly gels. And by jelly, I'm talking about consistency. So let's just jump straight in here and let's talk about the jelly gels first. So the two jelly gels that I'm kind of using as an example today are the Camille Rose Curl Maker and the Kinky Curly Curling Custard. You can find both of these tagged in my Amazon shop. I'll also go ahead and link them below in the description box. So when I say jelly, I mean jelly. Both of these products are very sticky, jelly, and ooey gooey. And because of this consistency, you're gonna get a completely different look than if you were to use a not so jelly gel. But we'll talk about those in a little bit. When you see a jelly gel, that's like kind of fun to say, jelly gel, jelly gel. Anyway, so when you see like a jelly kind of gel, you should know right off the bat that it's a little bit more heavy in consistency. So these typically will hold on to the most wildest curls and kind of control them. It will also kind of sit on top of your hair, but not necessarily like in a bad way. So I personally noticed when I use more jelly type of gels, they are more of the gels that will leave like a cast on my hair, you know, that crunchy curl cast. Again, not necessarily a bad thing, because the best kind of jelly gels will actually be able to fluff out. So that cast, once your hair is fully dry and it's nice and defined to the gods, you can then usually fluff it out through your curls, crunch away that cast, not have any flakes, and be good to go. But again, that's only with the best jelly gels. These two I highly recommend. They're two of my favorite jelly type of gels for like extreme holds. Whenever I'm looking for major definition, the jelly gels are what I'm reaching for. Because they do kind of sit on top of the hair a little bit more, they're kind of good for that sealing action. So if you have mid to high porosity hair, then this will be really good to help seal some moisture into your hair. So you're slapping in that leave-in conditioner, putting your jelly gel on top, and then your curls are gonna be held nice and strongly, but also like sealed in with moisture, nice and juicy. I also noticed that with the jelly gels, you can sometimes get a little bit more shine than you would with the regular, like not so jelly gels. So if you're ever looking for like that wet look, you know, that fancy, cute little wet look, or if you're just looking for super, super defined curls, like more definition than volume, and something that's gonna last and hold your curls throughout the entire week, the jelly gels are definitely what you're gonna wanna reach for. All right, so let's talk about the not so jelly gels. So I'm gonna be using the Wee Dad Advanced Climate Control Heat and Humidity Gel as an example. So obviously, yes, it's still a gel, so it's still gonna have a little bit of stickiness to it, but it's definitely nowhere near as jelly in consistency as the other two I showed you before. Another product example of a not so jelly gel is one that I've been using on Instagram a lot lately. If you guys follow me in there, you know what I'm about to say, but it's the Curlsmith In Shower Style Fixer Gel. By the way, I would show y'all the Curlsmith In Shower Style Fixer, but it's completely done. I only had a little sample size, so it's gone, it's done, I'm sorry. But again, I will link all the products that I'm mentioning in here below so that you guys can check them out if you want to. So as you may have guessed, these are a little bit more lightweight, so if you want that strong hold, you're gonna have to use a little bit more product than you would have to use with those jelly gels. So definitely by using extra products, building up the product a little bit more, scrunching your hair a little bit more, you can definitely get a great high level of hold. It's just a mere fact of having to use a little bit more product than you normally would have. I personally found that these kind of gels work really well when your hair is drenched. Now, if you know me, you know that I always apply any gel, no matter what they are, while my hair is like soaking wet. With the jelly gels, I can kind of get away with, you know, stepping out of the shower a little bit, drying off a little bit, and then applying the gels. But I find with these other not so jelly gels, I have to do it in the shower while the water's still running and my hair is literally dripping. Like, that is when they work their absolute best. The thing I really enjoy about these not so jelly gels is that one, your hair dries a lot quicker, and two, you'll find that on day one, you're able to get a really good amount of volume. So for today, you guys see my hair, right? I have lots of volume, and this is day one. I just washed my hair about 3 hours ago, and I used the Wee Dad gel, and boom, like, we got curl definition. Not gonna lie, I used a lot, But we got a good amount of volume going on as well because it's so lightweight. So another difference is that this doesn't really sit on top of your hair so much. It kind of gets more absorbed, I guess, because it's not as heavy. It kind of just soaks into the hair shaft a little bit more. And then it doesn't really leave any cast that you need to fluff out. I fluffed it out anyway though, cause y'all know I love that volume. So basically the effect that I'm getting are curls that are defined but very soft at the same time. So there's really no cast on top. I would also say that these Less Jelly Gels might be a little bit better for low porosity hair. If your hair is like low porosity, you definitely don't want to be using products that are so heavy, because with low porosity hair you can tend to get build up like that, like super easy. So I definitely recommend the Less Jelly Gels for like super low porosity hair. I do also feel that with these gels there's a less risk of flaking. The more jelly, the more chance of flaking. But again, everything I'm mentioning in here is personally tried, tested, and true for me. I love all of these gels. So for me personally, I really can't pick between the gel types. I can't say one gel type is better than the other. You literally have to listen to your curls, see what they want, and also think about the look that you're going for. So I would definitely suggest these Less Jelly Gels if you are a girl who prefers big volume. Like if the one thing that you need out of your wash day is some big volume, those gels are kind of gonna take you in that direction. If you're the opposite and you like that wet look type of ringlet curls, don't care how much it shrinks, you just want to see that curl pattern popping through, then definitely I would go with the jelly gels for you. I personally kind of like to do a mix of the two. Sometimes I'm doing defined, sometimes I'm doing volume. I also actually experimented with using both gels the other day. If you follow me on Instagram, I put that on my stories the other day and it actually worked really well. I used the Curlsmith In Shower Style Fixer, so that was like the less jelly kind of gel, and then I used the Curl Maker, which is super jelly, on top of it so that I could get a little bit of shine, a little bit of hold, but then we still got some volume from like the inside and it was popping. It looked so good. So yeah guys, that is basically it. I hope you found this super useful. If you have any additional questions, go ahead and comment them below. I would also love for you guys to share with me some of your favorite gels, so go ahead and comment that below too. Thanks so much for watching guys. Don't forget to hit that thumbs up if you did enjoy this, and go ahead and make sure that you are subscribed. I know some of y'all sneaky in here just watching and not subscribing, but go ahead and subscribe, and also two more videos just right here. Nice and convenient. Catch y'all in the next one. Bye.